Hey everyone, today we're going to do another little kind of just basic info type video, and that is about colubrid snakes. With us today is Shoshone. Her name used to be Fritter. She is a northern pine snake, but I decided to go with my thing of themes for all the different snakes is that all of my North American colubrids that I've kind of acquired and didn't really have names and moving forward, I want to do the different North American Native American tribes. So, Shoshone! And I haven't decided on what her boyfriend that we just picked up's name is going to be. But anyway, she is a northern pine snake. She is of New Jersey locality. They're found naturally there in like the pine barrens there. And she is a colubrid snake. And what you may be asking, okay, I've said that word now a couple times, what is a colubrid snake? And for any of you guys who have already or are a little bit more well-versed in this, sorry for just the kind of quick little revamp. That is basically what is most snakes. So snakes are kind of broken into a couple categories based on what they are. There's vipers and elapids, so rattlesnakes, which are vipers and stuff like that, and elapids, cobras, and mambas. And we don't really talk about them a whole lot because really, let's be honest, they're part of the hobby, but they're not really part of the hobby. Let's just be honest here. They're really cool. I think they're amazing, but we're not really going to talk about them in this. Then there are the boas, so boaidae. So the boa constrictors, anacondas, dumerous ground boas, sand boas. There is Pythonidae, which they used to both just be Boaidae, but they have enough distinction where they've now broken those two, and that's all the different pythons, ball pythons, retics, all the stuff like that. And then after that, it's Colubridae, which is everything else. And so basically, they just kind of made this big collect-em-all dumpster, essentially, to describe a tremendous amount of variety in different genera and species. Well into the hundreds of different individual genera and species, all broken up into that, which all are considered technically colubrid snakes. So corn snakes, bull snakes, milk snakes, hognose snakes, those are all different types of colubrid snakes. And as you can tell, if you know a little bit about all those ones, they're all pretty distinct and very similar. And you know, they all have some similarities. Most of them are a little bit more evolved, but some of them are entirely different, like a worm snake, which, you know, are those cute little tiny things where they don't have legs. They eat like termite larvae and stuff like that. They're these tiny, tiny little snakes. They barely even resemble snakes. They look like worms or little pieces of like alive spaghetti or hair or something like that. Those are technically colubrid snakes. It's just kind of weird that everything kind of got lumped together. But because of that, we can say that colubrids are just a really cool group of snakes to keep because of how diverse they are. And there's, like I said before, there's a bunch of different type of ones. So there's like the corn snakes, milk snakes, rat snakes, which, you know, we've talked about in quite a few videos. They're very popular, stuff like that. Then you have like pine snakes and bull snakes like Shoshone here that are part of the Pituophis genus. And maybe we'll eventually do one on just those type of guys where they're snakes. These snakes have keeled scales. So their scales are very similar to a rattlesnake. So they are kind of rough. They're kind of hard. And they all have a very distinct way of hunting. They're not constrictors. They're kind of like a grab and go kind of a meal. Then you have things like hognose snakes, which they have kind of rougher scales like this too. They're not really keeled, but they're a lot harder than like a king or a corn or something like that. But they're actually rear-fanged venomous, which is a term that kind of gets thrown around a lot. And what that means is that, so these guys, they're not vipers. They're not elapids like cobras and stuff. These guys don't even actually have fangs. What they have is this kind of ridged, hollow tooth that isn't at the front of their mouths. It's kind of halfway to two-thirds of the way back, depending on the type of snake, that their venom actually kind of runs down. So they say that they kind of have to, like, chew on you a little bit to work it in, but that's not exactly true. They just kind of need to bite and hold on to you for a second. It's not a quick little rawr. And even then, it's because it's there, it is working. Even a little scratch, if they get, you know, halfway down, if they don't get just the front of their mouths, you can still get a small amount of a venomation. So to say that they have to really work that isn't necessarily true. But there's a wide variety of type of like rear fang venomous snakes. So like I said, there's the hognose, which are actually a very common, really good species of snake to keep. They're very reluctant to bite, and most people don't ever have any sort of reaction to that venom. Then there's stuff like Asian vine snakes and false water cobras, which are found down in South America. Those are also rear-fang venomous. They have, it's not anything too crazy. Then you have mangrove snakes or cat-eyed snakes, which are also starting to get a little bit of popular where they're allowed to be kept. They're very beautiful, very reactive snakes, but their venom actually can have a little bit more of like a medically significant effect for most people. And then there's the boomslang. So we all have heard about the boomslang. It's like one of the most dangerous venomous snakes. They're found in Africa. They're very arboreal. Their venom is very hemotoxic. They're actually a rear fang venomous colubrid snake. So there you go. That's a group of snakes that has little wormy blind snakes, corn snakes, this pine snake, which is bigger than any corn snake we'll ever see, and then a boomslang. It's insane that they just have all this crazy stuff. Sorry it's a little bit of a ranty video, but when you talk about a boa or a python, most people get that. And when you say colubrid, a lot of people just go, oh, okay, yeah, what is that exactly? And it's kind of hard to say. It's literally everything else. But it's just a little bit of a couple other examples that, you know, maybe you didn't necessarily think about or just kind of sit there and go, wow, taxonomy is this kind of really weird, crazy thing that is continuously changing and updating. And like at one point, corn snakes were actually considered rat snakes. That was their name, red rat snake, for years and years. But they've changed up taxonomy and all this other stuff. But for some reason, colubrid snakes are still this one just big family of snakes. And you are holding on tight, little girl. But thank you. Sorry, she's still technically in quarantine, so this is going to be the last snake that I mess with today. But she can be a little cantankerous at times, so I'm just super happy that she's being really good and just kind of holding on and cooperating. But hopefully this gave you something. It's a little bit of just kind of a food for thought little video. Nothing crazy. Hopefully it wasn't too ranty, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this, and it gave me an excuse to have Shoshone out. I love her to death. I've gotten super into North American colubrids and Pituophis in general. It's just a saying that I can't have a bunch of bull snakes or in Colorado. But these guys are absolutely amazing creatures. It's actually one of the rarest snakes in North America is a colubrid. That's the Louisiana pine snake. So in the, oh, you're making a little bit of noise. It's in the same family. Sorry, I got a little ranty there at the end, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. I'll talk a little bit about that later down the road. I can hear she's getting a little huffy. We'll wrap this up. Hopefully you enjoyed this. Let me know down in the comments if you had any questions, comments, anything like that, and I'll check you next time.